Robinson's got the girl in the room right now. Too complicated to get into. Let's just say that I wasn't about to let some judge decide how to spend the rest of my life. That's my choice, so I made it. Either way, it doesn't matter now, does it?
If it didn't, you wouldn't still be here. Maybe I can help?
Nah, I appreciate it, but it looks like you got your own shit to deal with. I'll figure it out on my own. Always have. Thanks, though.
If only I could tell my younger self what I would become.
I've got to get out of here. There's a ghost right over there in that cell. Don't you have some other place you can keep?
Can we really not see this?
You too? There's another one! Tell me you can't see this guy! He's right there!
Someone get-
Why do I get stuck with the crazy guy? What happened?
What does it look like? I died.
Yeah, I can see that. I meant, how did you die? Autopsies aren't this thorough when the cause of death is cut and dry.
I don't know. A bunch of pills. Some were sleeping pills. It was supposed to be peaceful. I didn't know that you wake up. What am I supposed to do now?
I wish I knew, kid. I'll let you know if I figure it out myself.
Isn't a spiderweb tattoo usually a symbol for time spent in prison? Why would this tattoo have two spiders?
But the tattoos might tell us something.
That's all I know. Focus on your work.
A little respect would be nice.
We don't pay you to analyze tattoos.
Yes, sir.
Each one of these keys is a felony. Each one. You get that, right? No? All right, it's your funeral. Sit tight, relax. You're gonna be here for a while.
Fuck!
All right, look. Look, I might be able to help you. Is your mom's book from the Bell Killer case here?
Yes, and it would probably help me find my mom, but as I told you before, you're dead. How can you possibly help me?
Hey, I know this place better than you. Now, who did your mom work with here? Who?
I don't know. She just called him Bastard.
Baxter. All right. His office was on the second floor. You stick with me, I'll get you there. Let's go.
Go where? They're watching.
Not for long.
Follow my lead. I'll get you past these cops and to the door on the other side.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Last time you got caught, Magellan.
Stay low, or they'll see you.
Machine?
Interrogation is harder than it looks.
move, girl. Nice job, kid. We're almost there.
I don't need a cheerleader.
Hey, I got us this far, didn't I?
Got yourself killed, Mr. Bullet Holes. Hey,
kid.
I hate these things.
I can't get across there. You're gonna have to help me.
Well, can't you just fly over it?
Fly? I'm a ghost, not a plane, all right? And look, you need me to tell you which office is his.
Duh. Don't read any of my thoughts, or think anything creepy. This doesn't make us even. Okay, man, get out.
I got this.
Healed her, buddy. That sickness she carried in her brain, you made it tolerable. Well, I guess you must be together now.
Each murder changes, the inner zeal is the same. This is why the killings seem random, unrelated. But the police can't see these connections. Except Officer Baxter. I can't say I trust him, but he's my only chance.
Detectives usually work the day shift.
Okay, but which office is Baxter's?
It's in the back hallway to the right.
Okay.
Are you trying to get caught? You're about as stealthy as a tornado.
Ugh, the desk was like that when we got here.
Yeah, I know.
How many places can you hide a book in one tiny little room?
Who knows?
Like someone was hiding your real rap sheet. Now I have proof.
He never used that blackmail file against me.
Sure, take your time. No rush, I'm sure the book will find itself.
All right, just calm down a second here. Cops don't hide things in plain sight. I just need to figure this out.
Can you check that voicemail message?
Okay.
Baxter, I told you, you're off the case. Now we need all the files and that psychic's book in my office, now.
Rex was still asking for the book, so it is probably still in here somewhere. Good.
Must be a latch inside that opens inward. I better tell the girl.
I think I found it.
Show me.
There's a button on the side of the gun rack.
Yes, this is it.
Oh, please tell me you understand what all these symbols are.
Yes, some of them. That's weird. The last thing she wrote is he knows about me.
Oh, God. That means he was after her.
You don't know that. Come on, we should move.
Oh, crap.
Wait, what is that? The museum. That's strange.
Why would this be in her book?
I don't know. Just take it and figure it out later.
She's here somewhere. I'll check here. Head toward the back office.
We gotta go. Stay out of sight.
Go, go!
Speed up, girl. Hold up, hold up. I need to make sure the coast is clear. Rex.
Who's that?
A cop you need to avoid. All right, you're gonna need to make a break for that room over there, but wait for my signal.
Hey, LT, hold up.
You know what this fire drill's all about?
Go, go, go. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
I got their crew sweeping the building.
What's your way to be?
Hey, Baxter, you still relying on that wizard lady?
You know I ain't into all that spiritual crap. But she's onto something. Results are results. You find a more reliable source, you let me know.
Tell you anything, son. I'm not homicide.
I've only been in the department for 6 months.
Crap, what is this place?
Bell Killer War Room. Everything we know about the case so far.
Well, I got what I need, so.
Hey!
Yeah.
You keep trying to do this alone, you're gonna get yourself killed.
How would I just leave it as. I'll owe you one.
Crap.
I can still remember my first day on the force. Salem PD was in this tiny building on the edge of town. It was old, crowded, and completely insufficient to handle the day-to-day operations. Protecting Salem was getting harder and harder. But finally, the city decided to convert the old armory into our new headquarters. And when we finally moved in, I couldn't believe how big and modern the place was. Not bad for one of the first buildings in Salem. Plus, it just felt right. It used to be the city's first line of defense in a wild frontier, and now it had resumed its post once again, only this time in a modern world. The first week was a little chaotic as we settled in. One officer reported that someone had removed his gun from his locker. It took him 20 minutes to track it down, and when he did, he found it leaning against the wall in one of the unoccupied offices. Also, the late-night station operator reported a strange phone malfunction. Occasionally, when someone would call in to report a shooting, the recording would just stop. The call would cut out, and the voice of the panicked caller would just loop over and over again until the phone was unplugged. Soon it was pretty clear that these strange occurrences weren't just honest mistakes or faulty phone lines. One evening, the medical examiner came running down the hall in tears. She noticed that her scalpels and other tools had gone missing. She went to get more from the cabinet, but stopped cold at what she saw in the reflection. A ghostly silhouette of a Civil War soldier was standing over one of the corpses. When she spun around, it was gone. She barely noticed how cold the room had gotten before running off. Of course, the guys didn't believe her. Hell, I didn't either. Till I saw it with my own eyes. I was working late and got up to get more coffee. As I rounded the corner, I saw it in the reflection of the trophy case. It was staring right at me. He lifted an old ghostly rifle and pulled the trigger. The trophy case fractured into a spider web of cracked glass, and I took off running. The captain didn't believe me and docked my next paycheck to replace the glass. I didn't care if people thought I was crazy. I know what I saw. People sometimes ask me if anyone else has seen it since, or if the specter still roams the halls. I always tell them the same thing. I wouldn't know. I transferred to Boston.